quarterfinal showing between Brazil, 10th seeds, and Germany, top seeds.
Brazil versus Germany. First game, Germany to serve. Level.
If you are just joining us, and Hugo Calderano had a win over Bastian Steger earlier today in four tight games. Ruan Phillis. Well, he took out Eric Juti. Effectively, I guess, the Brazilian number three. That was in straight games, so a little bit more efficiently than Calderano. Many would argue that the man in red is slightly fresher, but some would argue, well, Paul Calderano is more match type because he just played so many matches. He's only 21. He's not going to fatigue at that age too much, I'd imagine. But they had a very long four-hour contest last night against Croatia, in which he came through to the Brazilians. Terrific rally there. Calderano getting the better of that one. Chop, getting it done, as we've seen so often from this man. Knifing underneath the ball to get that cut. But my instinct tells me that Calderano has enough loading in the legs and all of the limbs to get that work on the ball on a regular basis to combat it. Defence beating attack on that occasion. Deadlock on the scoreboard.
It's always interesting to analyse the defender versus attacker after about 7-8 points, just to see how you think they've adapted to the backspin. And I think, Paul, you're absolutely spot on. He's got the power in his legs, he's got the fitness. The fact he's played all the games, I don't think is a relevant factor. He's a very, very fit young man. But the key to it is, can he read the spin? Can he spot if it's heavy backspin or not very much back? And I think he's passed the test so far. He's read the spin pretty well. So my prediction would be that Calderano is slight favourite here. And I think we'll see Phillis look to attack quite a bit. Because I suspect he's had a few problems against that heavy backspin. He's not quite sure about it yet. He's tentatively pushed it back because he's not sure. So that's encouraging from a Germany point of view. That shot there, not sure, so he just dabbled.
Six, five.
Calderano just having a few issues against that heavy backspin. I don't think it's the actual backspin. It's just knowing how much backspin's on the ball, reading the spin. Now, that has got heavy backspin. And he was slightly tentative on the topspin. Interesting to look at his training program, his training partners, and how often does he practice against defensive players. There just aren't that many defensive players in the world, full stop. China will have quite a few for their players to practice against. But I think, as you pointed out, Paul, in the championship division, there is one defensive player. And this is the gentleman that we're watching, and he's an unusual defender because he didn't chop the ball on his forearm. He topspins the ball back or steers it back. So I wouldn't class him as a purist defender. So Calderano, 9-6. That's where Calderano will make no mistakes. When he just guides the ball back with no spin, just a little bit of topspin maybe, and that's bread and butter to a player like Calderano.
6-10.
Four game points for Brazil. Topspin from Calderano there. If Felix is going to attack, he's got to attack hard. First game to Brazil, 11-7. Players back to their respective corners, and we'll pick up commentary.
Second game, Brazil to serve, level.
Players back for game two then. Calderano, one game to the good.
Hold. Yes. Lab one.
Well, the Brazilian coach with the arms aloft in protest.
I can see it clearly. 0-1.
Hugo just needs to flush that away and move on. Didn't allow that sort of slight upset to contaminate the next point. Very well done. These top athletes so good at compartmentalising each point one by one. That was a fine finish there. Very athletic.
1-2.
He's been like a man on a mission, Calderano, over the last 36 hours or so.
1-2.
Loving the change-up from him as well. Little sort of soft block in the middle there. Not much spin on it. Giving as good as he's getting, that's for sure. And against this awkward German player in Ruben Fillus. Fillus roaring gutturally because he's now on the scoreboard and he's just trying to G himself up. Simultaneously put Calderano off a little. I'm sure there's some of that in there. Very competitive affair, this. That will play. Got on the front foot and made it count there, Phyllis.
3-3.
On occasions, you wonder whether he's chosen the right ball to have a smack at, but... there, as you thought Calderano was building nicely to a smouldering finish, didn't quite happen. Ruan Phillis, resilient and dependable, rock solid there.
Frustration will set in for Calderano if he can't get the ball past Phillis. And that's what's happening now. Phillis is
six.
Returning most of what Calderano's throwing at him, and then he's picking off the odd winner like he did there as well. So at the moment, Phillis is looking in good shape. And of course, if the ball keeps coming back, you then start playing shots that you wouldn't normally play. You start taking on high risk shots. Again, he just didn't lift the topspin there. He came across the ball, didn't lift.
Oh! 8-3.
That time he didn't pick the nose spin. Little float shot, the float being looks like backspin, but there's no spin on the ball. Not that he can't play the ball, he just can't read the spin. Here it goes. So no spin. And watch him lift. There we go. No spin again. Lifts it. No spin to lift.
9-5.
Mixed the play well, hasn't he? And been incredibly watertight to get to where he's got in this game. 5 game points for Ruan Phillis.
Left. 10-5. Left. 10-5.
Gain that last one. Secured at 11-5. Can he continue in that vein? Oh, fabulous. So early from Hugo Calderano there. And he's got those kind of skills to just crunch through the chopper. But it's about tempered aggression, picking the right ball and doing it with consistency. And at the moment, you can see there's a little hesitancy. It's not entirely convincing. And this is what a good defensive player does to you. Really making life hard and causing doubt, hesitancy in the mind of the man in black.
One.
Thanks. And again, another error spills from the racket of Hugo Calderano. He's starting to look just not quite as convincing as he was last night, that's for sure. He was bullying his way through. Scoreboard parity again. Well, this match has got everything, hasn't it? All of the mixes, the spins, the speeds, the no spins, the drops, the good use of the table. Fascinating matchup in contrasting styles. What a turnaround from Ruan Phillis. Take a bow. That was a terrific point. Feel like a real wounder for Calderano, you'd imagine, having invested so much in that point and come out with the point lost. And he had the upper hand and it was neutralised and turned around so effectively by the man in red. And the seasoned campaigner breaks to the front in this critical third game. Saw his countryman, did Calderano, Eric Duty, suffer and be put to the sword by this very opponent. So he'll want desperately to avenge his defeat. Was it an edge?
Timeout.
And, well, it definitely was. So a 3-point gain in favour of Ruan Phillis here. Brazilians have called a timeout.
And that I think he's very good. So let's see if he does a short serve here. There, that those sorts of shots. Now with his pimp, he's a bit further away now.
And I guess the problem being, Don, you kind of touched on it early so eloquently, but this guy, presumably, as you say, he is unique in what he does, and it must be quite unsettling because you train certain patterns, no doubt about it, with the modern game, and you probably don't get this sort of opponent too often. So it's quite unnerving for a man that's looking for certain set plays and his brain is... neuro system is wired away that he specs the ball in certain places and he's not getting that. Calderano, that is. He's done it again. The master at turning defence into attack. German fans loving what they're seeing right now.
World class.
Eight, four.
Stark reminder of, hang on, I'm 12 in the world. I'm an up-and-comer. Have some of that. So two blistering points, one from each.
Eight, four.
Is he onto something there? That flashed backhand down the line towards the forehand of Fuss. He doesn't seem to be guarding that side at all.
Six, eight.
Three in a row for the Brazilian now.
Time out.
This time it's the Germans that have called time out. He was rampant. Super acceleration there. There's a real urgency in his movement now.
There, I thought, from Felix there.
Yeah, he had the 8-3 lead, the man in red. Suddenly now that's been negated with some brilliant, gutsy, courageous table tennis from Calderano. He's loaded in a lot of high percentage into his game now. He's added a lot more spin and security just in case. And he's happy to trade that extra ball should he need. By the looks of things, six consecutive points. Super play, John. Tying him up right into the body. Outstanding. Seven in a row.
8-3 down. 10-8 up. Amazing.
The smacks of quality and belief, more importantly. This could be tie-turning, this kind of stuff. Just swiveled on its axis, courtesy of Hugo Calderano and some absolute fireworks. Look at that look.
One.
Super play, mixing it really nicely, throwing the dropper in there as well, just to keep Fuss off guard. Calderano really is a man on a mission right now. There were some routine misses from him earlier in the match, a couple of games ago, but he's tidied up. Far fewer unforced errors, far more creativity and percentage with it. He's a man on a mission. And it's extremely focused, very solution orientated. Always caught the edge. It was always coming, wasn't it? Rendered it uncontrollable.
3-3.
Back and just guides it, uses the top spin, it kicks, and that's won him a couple of points. He's won 4 points, two of them have been by using the spin already on the ball. It's a good return. He's in a situation where he knows he's got to attack if he gets the opportunity. He's got to break up the rhythm Calderano's getting into. Did that nicely.
Spilling long there.
Calderano knows he can topspin into the backhand. He knows then that Felix is only going to chop the ball back unless he occasionally runs round. Watch for him running round, then get it wide to his forehand. No need to take any high risk shots.
Increasing acceleration on each of those vicious forehands. Look how coiled he is. Rotating the upper body so fast, it just becomes a bit of a blur and so hard to track the ball in real time.
Seven, seven.
Doesn't need that right now.
You can serve off, I can serve off.
Now, how courteous. So three relative unforced errors there. Just when they need to be most frugal, these two. It's become Christmas time. Sensible choice to go cross table there and give himself that extra distance to play with, and he loaded it with spin and banana. Two points from the match now, then, Calderano.
Seven, eight.
So 9 points apiece. Third towel break of the match. It'll be the last one. Probably.
9-9.
Terrific turn of pace from the German this time. You're more familiar with watching Calderano explode, but that was timely. It's a brilliant game. What a turnaround from Ruan Phillis there. 11-9. Germany 2-1 up here, and we're locked in at two games all in this critical match. So he's won the last 3 points, Phyllis. Staring down the table as if to say, I own this, this is my territory.
Two soft points, really. Calderano can't afford to give those sorts of points away. Phyllis will be delighted with his start. He'll be happy now to take one of the next two against the serve. All the time, it just puts a little bit more pressure on Calderano. Oh, he hesitated then on the push. Wasn't sure how much backspin was on the ball. Watch how he tentatively pushes that. It
flies off, doesn't it?
Very tentative. Basically, he wasn't sure of the spin. Now, surely he's not going to go five love up when the change ends.
So that's actually six consecutive points for Phyllis when he includes those last two in the game prior as well. He is in the driving seat here.
But it will be such a big advantage psychologically to change ends at 5-love.
Yes. Yes. Got it. Yeah, absolutely. And he has used every ounce of his competitive prowess and years on tour as the senior statesman here, 9 years older than Calderano.
And you and I were saying during the break that we fancied Phyllis now.
5-love.
Psychologically putting Calderano under a bit of pressure after winning that fourth game. Still a long way to go.
5-5.
Hugo's adding a lot more safety and height and work on the ball to ensure that last point. But
it was the third game, wasn't it, when it was 8-3 for Phyllis.
Yes, that's right. And he suddenly, the Brazilian just ignited,
11-8.
Didn't he?
He's got 8 points on the run.
Yeah,
so he's, if he ignites again,
1-5.
We've got one hell of a game on.
Yes.
One, 6.
He thought about rigging over, didn't he, that one?
That's cruel. That is literally unreturnable. Just watch this, watch it. Here it comes. Hits the net, balances on the net, then comes back over.
Beg your pardon, I thought it'd gone the other way, right?
Wow.
Let 1-6.
Still keeping an ever-menacing presence in this set, Calderano, with all of his explosivity and highly tuned game.
A little bit more topspin on the serve this time than Calderano thought. Lifted the ball, it didn't need lifting.
from Calderano.
What warriors these two are. Highly competitive affair. From start to finish, look at that. Talking of finishes, that was exemplary.
I think Felix needs to look to attack a couple of balls just to break up this run of top spins from Calderano.
Super play from Calderano. What presence of mind there to be that cool to play the dropper from a high ball like that as well. That is high-risk territory, but he's pulled it off. And that will really unsettle Ruan Phillis, you'd imagine.
So it's 4-2 since we changed ends at 5-love. In favour of Calderano, the last 6 points.
He's done it again. He's producing the magic when he needs it most, the man in black. You'd imagine Phillis's head will be like a washing machine right now. Just spinning. Steps off stage temporarily, turns his back on proceedings, tries to settle down.
He needs to be creative behind this serve. More of an error than a point one.
3 points away now, Ruan Phillis, as a consequence of this forehand spilt over the back line. Can he capitalise? Oh! Where did that come from? Hugo. Remarkable shot. Yes. He swats it away dismissively. He's still in touch.
Very much in touch.
Yeah. Soft error.
Service there. That's a delicate touch shot. Just touching it short and wide to Calderano's forehand. Watch. There it is. Second bounce was going to be on or about the baseline, so he knew he had to then cut change, play over the table, as opposed to let the ball come long. Not the best serve. Can't afford to let him attack the serve.
I think he should have taken the receive on a little more positively. It doesn't matter. We're at 9-8. What next here? All set up. Got what it deserved. Bringing deadlock on the scoreboard yet again. And this nervy nail-biter, the Brazilians have been imbued in this situation over the last 36 hours or so. Had the same kind of situation this time last night against Croatia, where they escaped somehow and eked out the win 3-2. This is a must-win match for Calderano, as you can see on that score graphic.
Thank you.
feels long.
It hit the top of the net, I think.
Yeah, it did.
Hit the top of the net, flew off the end of the table. Team point. Team match point to Germany. It did. It just caught the top of the net, flicked it off the end.
Deep breathing skills all round. The man.